Think love conquers all? Think again. The truth is that there are millions of men out there that you shouldn't marry, no matter how much you love them. Luckily, there are plenty of men who are ready for marriage and who would make great husbands. In this video, I'll cover the 5 types of guys you should avoid so that you can save time for your real soulmate. Hi, I'm Emily Baker from Love Learnings. As a relationship coach and love expert, I've helped hundreds of women find the relationships of their dreams. And along the way, I've learned to sniff out the guys who just aren't ready for marriage. It doesn't mean that these guys aren't good men who are extremely attractive and fun to be around. It simply means that in the long run, if they don't change, they won't treat you right. Let's get into it. Number 1, the fixer-upper. Why is it that women love to date a fixer-upper? Well, it turns out that there are several reasons that the fixer-upper is attractive. For starters, we like the idea that we managed to spot a diamond in the rough. Plus, if we're really able to work our magic and turn this dud into a stud, we can take credit for his success. And on some level, we feel that if he's lacking in certain areas, this gives us a leg up on him in the relationship. But like a Snuggie, a fixer-upper may be comforting at first, but always just ends up being messy and impractical. And the reason turns out to have more to do with us than it does with him. Here's why. A guy who you see as a fixer-upper almost certainly doesn't see himself that way. He, like all of us, just sees himself as someone doing their best and living their life in the way they choose. This disconnect will be your downfall. Since you've fallen in love with the potential you see in him rather than who he actually is, he's bound to disappoint you again and again. And from his POV, he's gonna eventually see that you don't truly respect him all that much. I mean, you are comparing him to a cheap, rundown house. So, if success is important to you, avoid the fixer-upper, and instead look for men who are living up to their potential. Then you'll be able to put your energy into a place where it's more welcome. 2, the lost sheep. He's rudderless, without goals or even a basic direction in life. He changes up his style, his beliefs, and his career week to week, to the point that you never know who's gonna walk through the door. This isn't to say that this guy will be lost forever, but there are 2 possible bad scenarios here. 1, he continues to drift through life, not making any strides to better himself or his situation, and you're caught in his wake. The two of you are never gonna be able to afford the life that you want. 2, he eventually finds his calling in life, and he's elated. He's gonna go work on an alpaca farm in Patagonia. See where I'm going with this? I'm not saying that everyone needs a watertight 5-year plan in order to be marriage material, but it's best to have at least a general direction in life before you think about making the ultimate commitment. When you're in a period of upheaval, there's a good chance that you won't even be the same person 3 years from now. So how can you be expected to commit to someone for life? And unfortunately, the same goes for you. If you feel as though you're still finding yourself and your place in the world, then you need to think carefully before you decide to push forward into marriage. I think that this is one of the big reasons that we've seen the marriage rate plummeting in recent years. As the world becomes increasingly uncertain, we lose confidence that the future we imagine will actually come to pass. Sad, but true. Number 3, the non-stop grinder. Ambition is healthy, but only to a point. If your boyfriend is someone who puts his goals above all other priorities, then marrying him isn't gonna make him suddenly change his ways. We all know this classic scenario, the husband who's always busy with work. He says that when things slow down a little, he'll finally be able to take her on that trip they've always talked about. But 1 month passes, and then 2, and pretty soon it becomes apparent that things are never gonna slow down. This is because he's an ambitious, driven guy who puts all of his energy into his professional life. This leaves him drained and irritable when you do finally get some one-on-one time with him. At the same time, once he's set this pace for himself, he can't slow down or risk losing his whole identity. This is all too common in modern marriages, since men who choose to marry are often quite ambitious. They're following the conventional life path. Work hard, meet that special someone, settle down, and have a couple kids. Many of us take this path because we feel that it's the right thing to do if we want to be happy and fulfilled. This makes it especially hard to establish a more healthy work-life balance, since we've been told that this is just how things are supposed to be. Spotting the non-stop grinder can be difficult. They come in different forms. Check out the movie Free Solo for just one example. It features Alex Honnold, a chill rock climber who is so hyper-focused on scaling rock walls that he won't make time for his relationship.
What if something happens? What if I don't see him again?
I could just walk away, but it's like, I don't want to.
Here are some things to look out for. Has he ever missed important events due to work? Does he treat his side business like a side chick? Is he able to have downtime without checking his email or doing a little bit of work here and there? If he can't relax and focus on you when you need him most, how likely is it that that'll change once you're married? But this one is a two-way street. If you're a career woman with ambitions as big as your shoulder pads, you also may not be ready for marriage right now. In fact, I'll let you in on a little secret about this list. A woman who fits into any of these categories also shouldn't get married just yet. And that's okay. There's no reason to rush to get married like there was in the past. Only when you accept yourself as you are right now will you be able to grow and change into the person you want to be. Are you looking to attract and connect with better men? I have just the thing for you. Head on over to coachnorth.com after this video is over and check out the free presentation there. I've been working with Amy for a few months now, and she's helped me to really understand how psychology impacts our ability to form relationships in ways I never imagined. Check it out now at coachnorth.com. Number four, the roller coaster. Katy Perry said it best. He's hot, then he's cold. He's yes, then he's no. He's in, then he's out. He's up, then he's down. We've all met men like this, and surprise, surprise, they actually don't make great husbands. While this may be obvious, I think that it's something that needs to be said because these men are actually more likely to propose than your average guy. This is because the teeter-totter relationships they create are prone to move too quickly. When you go from breaking up to moving in together in an instant, then eloping isn't much of a stretch. Here are some ways to spot the roller coaster in action. He breaks up with you and then comes crawling back. He takes every argument to the extreme. He's prone to big mistakes and bigger apologies. His moods seem out of step with what's actually happening in reality. This kind of emotional whiplash can leave you exhausted and unable to focus on much outside of the relationship as it consumes more and more of your life. Remember that while a healthy relationship takes work, a partner who treats you right will add to your life, not just take from it. Number five, the doomer. Negativity has its place. It pushes us to improve ourselves and our lot in life. But if he can't see the good in himself, the world, and the people around him, he just might be a doomer. This goes beyond simple low self-esteem, although it is a crucial part of it. Here's a common refrain for this type of guy. I'm such a piece of shit. I don't even know why you're with me. While the occasional moment of insecurity is fine, this kind of low self-esteem can be toxic. That's because while it may seem counterintuitive, this kind of negativity is actually quite narcissistic. In his world, everything revolves around his own personal issues. He can't treat you properly because he can't treat himself properly. He can't take care of your needs because he can't take care of his own. This kind of negative thinking often has roots in depression and anxiety. While I'd never caution you against marrying men with mental health issues, it's about how these issues manifest that can cause real problems. I'm sure we all know people with pretty severe issues who are still able to treat others with respect. It also comes down to the willingness to face your issues and seek help. There you have it. That's five men that you should never marry. But before I go, I should say that none of the guys on this list are beyond help. Many of these issues can be sorted out with time or will naturally fall away as people grow and mature. I think we've all gone through one or two of these phases personally, and it doesn't mean that we're not worthy of love. But until he's found a better footing in life, he's not a guy who's ready for marriage. Thanks for watching all the way to the end. I'm Emily Baker. While you're here, I would love if you could like this video and subscribe to my channel. It really helps me out. Thanks for watching.